module 1.
Good morning, ma'am.
If we see the syllabus of our course 201, that is quality and management in school education, in that unit number 4, that is components of school management and administrative setup in education. So in that unit, you can say from that unit, we have covered two topics, that is school records and co-curricular activities, and the remaining 3 topics still pending. So I'm going to start with the next topic. Okay. So before that, just tell me, if we see here, we are talking about the secondary and higher secondary education. So just recall the various schools in your vicinity and tell me to which board they are affiliated, and just tell me names of those schools also. Okay, be interactive. Yes.
Ma'am, are you asking by our schools we have visited or we know that school?
Yes, yes, you can give any example.
Yes,
any example.
Ma'am, there is a school in my premises, Ajink D.Y. Patil.
Okay.
It's an international affiliated board school. And
okay.
Nearby also, there is a Marthopolis school, which is affiliated of CBSE board.
Okay.
And last year when we did our internship with Vaishnavi Vidya Vihar, which was a state board school.
Okay. So what is name of state board of this Maharashtra?
Maharashtra state board.
Yes, you are closer to the answer. See, mostly we are talking about the SSC and HSC board. Okay. Just forget about the name of the board. Tell me what is the full form of SSC and HSC. Because we all have completed SSC and HSC. Just forget about the affiliation of that particular school to the different kinds of boards. Just forget about that also. Just tell me full form of SSC. Of course, we all have completed SSC and HSC, right? Because that is nothing but the secondary and higher secondary educations. So just tell me, what are the full forms of SSC and HSC?
Ma'am, HSC is higher secondary certificate.
Okay, good. And what about SSC?
Senior secondary.
No.
State board, state secondary board.
No, it's the meaning of
secondary SSC school certificate.
Very nice, Sonali. That is nothing but the secondary school certificate, and SSC means higher secondary certificate. So sometimes we are recognizing that state board, that is SSC and HSC board, but the main name of that board, that is Maharashtra State Board of Secondary and Higher Secondary Education. Okay, now I'm going to share the screen. A screen is visible to everyone. Yes.
Yes, ma'am.
So what you can see on the screen? About the mind map?
Mind mapping.
Yes. Okay, yes, good. Okay, today we are going to learn this topic. We are going to know much more about the SSC and HSC board. Okay, by drawing this mind map. Okay, and now I'm going to tell you about this board in detail about. So we'll study one by one. We'll see about the, where is the main center, what are the divisions, and about the main tasks of the SSC and HSC board, about the administrative setup, we can say, what are the functions of this board, and about the curriculum. Okay, so do you know that where is the main center of this SSC and HSC board, or we can say the Maharashtra State Board of Secondary and Higher Secondary Education? Yes. Because we are in Pune, my dear ones. Don't know,
ma'am. Last year I did
class 11th English, Yuva Bhakti boards detail explanation. So, ma'am, it was written there. Maharashtra State Bureau of Textbook Production and Curriculum Research based in Pune.
See, that textbook bureau, that is another agency. If we see, there are so many agencies related to education boards. Here we are not talking about the agencies, here we are talking about the board, and especially these are the boards that are related to the secondary and higher secondary education. Okay, and of course some boards, they are producing textbooks also, they are manufacturing textbooks also, but we are not talking about the agency. Whatever you are telling us, that is about the textbook bureau. Okay, so here I'm talking about the SSC and HSC board. I think it is very closer to us. It is at the Shivaji Nagar, Pune. If you see the main we can say the parent agency, it is located in the Pune, that is Maharashtra State Board of Secondary and Higher Secondary Education. Okay, आपने देखा नहीं, ये जब हम शिवाजी नगर जाते हैं वहीं पे वो बहुत बड़ा बिल्डिंग है उसका, एसएससी एंड एचएससी बोर्ड का. ओके, बहुत बार ऐसे होता है हम जहाँ पे रहते हैं हमें बहुत सारी चीजें मालूम नहीं पड़ती. ओके, लेट इट बी. सो लेट्स सी अबाउट द फॉर्मेशन. सो दिस एजेंसी, नॉट एजेंसी, दिस बोर्ड, इट इज एस्टैब्लिश्ड इन 1966 ऑन 1st January. And if you see the initial name of this Maharashtra State Board of Secondary and Higher Secondary Education, it's only Maharashtra State Board of Secondary Education. See, and this board, this of course this is the state board. Okay, and this board established in 1966 under the Act of Maharashtra State Government, and in 1977 the minor changes were made in the nomenclature. You can see the name of this state board, and now whatever name now we can see, that is the new name of the state board. Okay, so initial name was Maharashtra State Board of Secondary Education, and now we are recognizing this board as a Maharashtra State Board of Secondary and Higher Secondary Education. Okay, so this is about the introduction. And if we see in the field of secondary and higher secondary education, this is the state's highest educational body. Okay, and the headquarter is located in the Pune. Official language, if you see the main official language, that is Marathi, but apart from that they are also using English. And you can search, there is a number of information is given on the website about the different agencies, about the different boards. So you will get information about these board. Of course these board, they are having their own website also, so you'll get more information about these board on the website. Okay, so do you know that what is the main task of these board, that is SSC and HSC board? Yes. Yes, students, I want interactions from your side. Yes.
Ma'am, I guess the main task of these boards are to provide guideline and
okay,
give rules and regulations, set rules and regulation for that particular HSC and SSC.
Okay, you want to say about the standards?
Yes, okay. Ma'am, setting
standards. See, so what we are saying that the particular school is affiliated to the particular board. So here we are talking about the state board. State Board of Maharashtra, SSC and HSC board. Some schools, they are affiliated to the central board, that is the CBSE board. Some schools, they are affiliated to the international board, it can be IB. There are different names of IB boards. Okay, so this is nothing but the affiliation. But if we see the main task of SSC and HSC board, that is related to the conduction of exams. See, it is related to the conduction of exam. So, which exams they are going to conduct? Of course, SSC and HSC. So, here they are going to conduct exam of 10th standard and exam of 12th standard. So, this is the main task of this board. Now tell me, so suppose as a teacher, whenever you are going to conduct any, suppose you are the exam in charge in a particular school, okay, and you are going to conduct exam for the entire school, so what you will do? So so as a exam in charge, what are your tasks? Just tell me one by one. Yes,
ma'am, as an exam in charge, ma'am, first of all, I would ask to so a particular subject teacher to set the question papers.
Okay,
on
good.
Submission of papers on time.
Okay.
Before the exam. Mm-hmm. And according to the student's roll number, the seating arrangement should be proper.
Yes, good.
And timetable of the examination, date, day wise.
Okay, good. I want answers from other students also. Be interactive. Yes. Yeah, very nicely you are giving answers. See, whatever just now, whatever points I got from you, that is related to the paper setting, related to the sitting arrangement, related to the timetable, okay? But I think before that, so as an in charge, you should give notice to the concerned teachers, right? Because we are going to held exam, right? We are going to held exam between this duration, and so for that you have to set the papers. Okay, and again you can give the brief idea about the outline of the papers. Okay, so that is nothing but the notice. Okay, then you will see about the sitting arrangement. Of course, after getting notice, the teachers, they will start paper setting. Okay, then you will think about the sitting arrangement, because you are going to hold exam for the entire school. So how many classes are there, how many divisions are there, even the strength of the students, the theory papers for which you are going to conduct the exam. So everything matters, and by considering everything, you are going to set the timetable, you are going to set the time slots for the examination, because you may have the less infrastructure, right? Or sometimes you are having the less infrastructure and you are going to conduct the exams on the same date, on the same period. So at that time you can hire, you can take help of other schools also for holding examinations, or you can take help from other agencies also. Okay, then after that you're going to conduct exam. Suppose examinations are done, then what will be the next step? Yes. Yes, students, so what will be the next steps after conduction of the exam?
Yes. Providing results.
Yes, but before providing results, the concerned teachers, they should check the papers, right?
Yes.
Then there will be declaration of the result. So this is the basic procedure which takes place. So we can say this is the basic planning which takes place at the school level. But here we are talking about the state board. They are going to conduct exam for the 10th and 12th standard. So see if you see the scope, it is very wider, right? So here what they have to do, so first of all they have to send the circular about the conduction of the examination. We are going to hold the examination in the month of Feb, in the month of March, and even the duration. Okay, so first they are going to send the circular to the concerned division boards, we can say, and the division boards, they will take care of sending circulars to the schools. Then they have to take care of the sitting arrangement. Just think about all schools, they are not conducting these examinations, because they are not having that much infrastructure. So just take example of any particular village, okay, and the village is having, they're having, suppose, 3-4 schools they are having, right? But there is a one big school. So that can be center for conduction of the examination, and the remaining 3 school students, they will come there for the for giving examinations. So they have to select the centers for the examinations. So this is nothing but the sitting arrangement. आप भी देखते हो, अभी भी हम कोई exam देते हैं. For example, we'll take example of our course, B.Ed course. Now we are having center for conduction of the B.Ed exams. Okay. Now this is the pandemic situation, so we don't know so what kind of examinations you supposed to give this year, but there are certain centers. But because I remember that initially we supposed to go to the Mozi College, because the Mozi College, that is the center for the conduction of the B.Ed examination. The same system is here in the conduction of the SSC and HSC examination. So this is about the sitting arrangement. Okay. Then there should be timetable. So this board, they should send a timetable to the concerned divisional boards, and the divisional boards, they will send timetable to the concerned schools. Even that they are nowadays, it is very easy because they are having their own website and everything is displayed on the website. So the concerned schools and the divisional boards, they can access anything from the website also. Then, as you told me that there should be paper setter, but here at the school level, the subject teacher is the paper setter, but here the experienced teachers, they are selecting certain teachers, because in university also, we'll give example of our university. So those who are having approved teachers in case of B.Ed, suppose the university, they are going to select teacher educators for the particular subject as a paper setter. So university, they are having our details with them. We are having the teacher's profile, and every details are there on the teacher's profile. So they are checking our profiles, and as per our profiles, as per our experience, they are selecting us as a paper setter. So same thing, this SSC and HSC board, they are doing for selection of the paper setter. And they have to select moderators also, because after conduction of the exam, there is the paper checking. Okay, so checking part is there, and moderation part is also there. So do you know what is the difference between the checking and the moderation? Yes students, what is the difference between the checking and moderation? If you don't know answer, please give me any kind of reaction. If you don't know, then please tell me we don't know.
Ma'am, checking is just take the paper.
Yes.
If the answer is right or wrong.
What moderator is doing? Suppose there is a bundle of 30 papers, okay, and see, initially what happens, the papers, the boards, they are sending papers to the teachers at their home. But nowadays they are doing paper checking and even the moderation at the particular centers. Okay, so paper checking, suppose there are certain teachers, they are doing paper checking part, and after paper checking, there is a moderation. So what moderators are doing? Paper checking to ho gaya, teachers ne paper check, concerned subject teacher jo bhi hai, unhone paper check to kar diye. Uske baad kya hone wala hai? Uske baad moderation hone wala hai. So moderation ki, why there is necessity of moderation? What moderator is doing actually? Kya karta hai moderator wahan pe? Yes.
Ma'am, I think so. Moderator give a guidance to the student, or it can connect to student and the control panel.
See, actually, after paper checking, suppose there is a bundle of the 30 papers with the teacher, and after checking all these papers, the same Mendel is going to the moderator, towards the moderator. Then what moderator is doing? So moderator randomly, so those students, they are getting fail, those students, they are getting XX marks or the good marks. So he is doing moderation of the all the papers, and that moderator is checking those papers again. So वहाँ पे there should not be biasness, there should not be objectivity का कोई सवाल ही नहीं, because अभी हम लोग holocrafts use करते हैं, अभी कोई भी चीज़ reveal नहीं होती, we don't know कि हमारे पास किसका paper है, कौन से student का है, कौन से area का है, we don't know. So moderators वो क्यों होते हैं? क्योंकि किसी को injustice नहीं मिलना चाहिए, सबको justice मिलना चाहिए. तो those who get fail in the particular paper, so moderator is again checking all these papers ki sahi se uska checking kiya gaya hai ki nahi, uska assessment sahi tarike se kiya gaya hai ki nahi, wo moderator check karte hain. Theek hai, aur uske baad baad mein there is a declaration of the result. So yahan pe ye jo declaration hota hai wo kaun karta hai? Of course the board. But yahan pe ye possible nahi na ki har ek cheez. So is it possible for principal to take care of each and everything? Of course not, because there are different heads of the department, there are different departments, and each department is having its own head. Har ek department ka ek head hota hai. See, because of this is very easy for the administration. Okay, so like same, this is the SSC and HSC board, the main headquarter, or you can say the parent board, it is at the Pune. But apart from this, they are having different what you can say, they are having different divisions. Okay, so let me share one other. Okay, this screen is visible now. What we can able, what we, you can able to see? Yes, students.
Maharashtra State Board of
Secondary and Higher Secondary Education. Okay, you can see here that is the formation date. It is given here. Okay, headquarter, it is in the Pune. Official language, it is Marathi, and they are also nowadays they are also using English language. And here the chairperson, that is Gangadhar Mamane. He is the chairperson. The secretary, Krishna Kumar Patil. Krishna Kumar Patil, he is the secretary. And see here what he get is, this is the parent organization, and the what is the divisions, we can say that they are the sister organization, we can say. And see how many schools they are affiliated. So till 2020, total 10,654 schools are affiliated to the Maharashtra State Board, and this is the website you can see here. Okay, now I'm going to tell you about the different divisional boards. See here, you can see there are 9 divisional boards. Actually, they are also in Pune. It is also, see, main headquarter, it is at Pune, but Pune, it is also one divisional board. So total 9 divisional boards are there. Okay, Amravati, Aurangabad, Kolhapur, Konkan, Latur, Mumbai, Nagpur, Nasik, and Pune. So initially only 8 divisional boards were there, but now there is one more addition, that is Konkan divisional board. Okay, so this is about the divisional boards. Okay, then about the administrative setup, so we'll see about the, see later on I'm expecting that, I'm just highlighting here the main points, and I'm expecting that after completion of the lecture, so if you have this video, you can use this video, or you can find some this information about this topic on the website, and I'm expecting that it will be good for you if you prepare this mind map by your own. Okay, so I'm giving you just main points. On the basis of this, you can prepare mind map. So here we are talking about the administrative setup or administrative and setup. Okay, so here the chairman, who is the chief executive of the board, and he is assisted by the secretary, then there is assistant secretary, there is account officers. Okay, and they are taking care of all the matters concerning examination, administration, finance, etc. And for making simplicity, just I told you that for making simplicity in the administrative process, there are these functions are followed by the different divisions. And we saw there are total how many divisions are there? Just tell me the number. Yes. Including Pune, how many divisions? Yes, there are 9 divisions. Dear students, please focus on these main parts, this small parts, because if the university has decided, I don't know what the university has decided, but if university will decide to take your examination in the form of MCQ, then these small things will help you. They will ask you about the establishment of the year, about the date, about the change in the name of this board, about the main tasks of this board, about the who is the chairman of this board, about the hierarchy. So such kind of questions they will ask in the form of MCQ. So while studying also, please focus on the main points. Okay. So this is about the administrative setup. Now what are the main functions? Of course, the main task we have studied before. Then apart from that, there are so many functions of this board. Ensuring a uniform pattern of secondary and higher secondary education. Okay, so there should be uniformity in the whatever syllabus or curriculum is there. There should be uniformity in the pattern of secondary and higher secondary education. Okay. I think Meenal, she has told you about the standards, and there should be uniformity in the standards of education. So usme bhi uniformity honi chahiye, kisme jo bhi standards of education hai regarding the secondary schools and the junior college. Of course you can, there is another name for the higher secondary, that is nothing but the junior college. Hum higher secondary waise hum wo use hi nahi karte, most of the time we are using that junior colleges. So it gives uniform standards. Try to recall and try to understand the functions of this board. The first is uniform pattern. The second is uniform standards of education. And see, if we see, it brings the proper coordination between the national policies, the state policies in the secondary and higher secondary education. So there is a connection between the national policies and the state policies. So such kind of boards, they are coordinating different policies at the national level and the state level. Then again, they have to keep the coordination between. See, here we are talking about the secondary and higher secondary education, but something is below that and something is above that, right? So what comes about that secondary and higher education, secondary and higher secondary education, what is below that and what is above that? Yes.
Are you asking about primary education?
Yes, yes. So here the secondary and higher secondary education, and there is a primary education below this level. And what is the above level? It can be the higher education, or the, you can say the university education. So again, this board, it kept the coordination, proper coordination. So you have to keep the coordination between the secondary and higher secondary education, university education, and or you can say the higher education and primary education. Okay. Again, one more function, that is it laid down guiding principle for determining curricula and syllabus. And they also prepare the detailed syllabus for all the standards of secondary and higher secondary education. See, the main, that is the examination. The second is the formation, uniform pattern. See, uniform pattern, then the uniform standards, then coordination between the policies at national and state level, then the coordination between the secondary and higher education with university education, or you can say the higher education and primary education, or you can say elementary education. Okay, you have to remember all these, the other names for the same. So elementary education, primary education. Okay, you have to recall and remember all these names. And then again, they are laying down guiding principle for the determining the curriculum and syllabus, and they're also preparing detailed syllabus for the all the, what you can say, all the standards of secondary and higher secondary education. Okay. apart from that, there are certain functions of this. After completion of the examinations, they are awarding certificate. Okay. See, the result is the another part. We are getting result. Hamare paas result aata hai. But apart from that, they are also giving us certificate. हम कोई भी एक डिग्री लेते तो डिग्री का सर्टिफिकेट मिलता है लाइक दैट ओनली आफ्टर कंप्लीशन ऑफ एसएससी आफ्टर कंप्लीशन ऑफ आफ्टर गिविंग एग्जामिनेशन और आफ्टर रिजल्ट्स वी आर गेटिंग सर्टिफिकेट फ्रॉम दिस कंसर्न बोर्ड ओके देन नेक्स्ट इज दे आर अगेन एंश्योरिंग द मेंटेनेंस ऑफ द एकेडमिक स्टैंडर्ड्स एंड द सेंट्रल और वी कैन से द पैरेंट बोर्ड इट इज एट द पुणे Okay, so one more functions they are having, that is to inspect and supervise generally the working of the divisional boards. See, there are total 9 divisional boards and the main, that is the parent board, that is the Pune, that is at the Pune. And here we are recognizing boards with the names of the districts. For example, the Nagpur and the Konkan, it is not district, it is the region. Okay, but some names of the districts are there as a divisional boards and some regions are there like the Konkan. Konkan is the region. Okay, so they are going to inspect and they are supervising the working of these divisional boards. Like principal, kya karta hai? Principal is taking care of and principal also supervising the working of the different departments. In the school, like that only, here also, this SSC and HSC board, the parent body, which is at Pune, they are going to inspect, they are going to supervise the different working of the different divisional boards. Okay, so this is about the functions of the SSC and HSC board. Then what about the curriculum? Yes. You know the difference between the curriculum. Curriculum, it is for the particular level. So here we are considering the two levels, that is secondary and higher secondary level. And curriculum is for the secondary level and the higher secondary level. Okay. So here, what included in the curriculum? Just tell me that. What included in the curriculum? Yes. So like you can compare that with your B.Ed subject. So there are some compulsory papers. So like that, there are some compulsory subjects. Okay. And these compulsory subjects, which includes 3 languages. So here at the secondary and higher secondary level, there is a study of 3 languages. It is compulsory. So can you tell me about the 3 languages, about the study of 3 languages? Yes. Yes, students.
Ma'am, could you please repeat the question?
Yes, yes, sure. See, if you see the B.Ed curriculum, just there are some compulsory papers. So like that, in this curriculum of secondary and higher secondary, there are some core subject, it also includes languages, and basically 3 languages are there. So can you tell me about these languages? Which study of languages included in the secondary level?
Ma'am, first would be regional language, or
okay,
in Maharashtra, Marathi would be the first language. Then Hindi, and then third word is English.
Very, very nice answer, Meenal. So first you can say the regional language, that is the first language we can say. Then second is the national language. Okay. And third is the English. Okay. Because this is the international language we can say. So first we have to consider about the regional language. Which is also, we can say the mother tongue. Abhi Maharashtrian log hai, unki mother tongue to Marathi rahengi. So either you can say mother tongue, or you can say mother tongue, or you can say regional language. So in case of Maharashtra, it is the Marathi. The national language, it is Hindi. And the English, that is the international language. So basically, the study of 3 languages, it is compulsory, or it is included in the core subject. And apart from that, there are 3 other subjects which are included in this core subject. So can you tell me names of those subjects? Just recall mark sheet of the subjects of your second subjects at your secondary level. Yes. Yes, students. Have you studied maths? Have you studied science? Have you studied social science? Yes.
Yes.
Okay. So basically, three languages are there, and apart from that, there are other three subjects: the mathematics, science, and social science. Okay. And these subjects are for the external assessment. So in if we I'm just going to comparing, so it will easy for you to remember to understand. So in B.Ed course also. There is an internal assessment and external assessment. Okay, so internal assessment it is done by the college and external assessment it is done by the university. So like that. So these are the core subjects and total six subjects are included there. Three languages, regional language, national language, and international language, and other three subjects that is the mathematics, science, and social science. Okay, so these subjects they are for the external assessment. Okay, and apart from that, there are also other subjects. So, can you do you know the names of the other subjects? So, apart from these subjects, other subjects are also included in the curriculum. Yes. And the other subjects they are assessed internally by the school. Just you have conducted your practice teaching internship. Just recall the timetable and tell me the names of the subject. Yes. Yes, fast. There is a PT period. There is a computer period. Yes. So many periods are there. So these are the different subjects. Health education is there. Some subjects they are based on the work experiences. Okay, some subjects are optional subjects are also there. Optional subject mein matlab kya hota hai ki do teen subjects hai usme se unko ek select karna hai. Theek hai, even the value education it is compulsory. General knowledge subject is also there. Okay, so these are the subjects and assessment of these subjects is done by the school. That is nothing but the internal assessment, and the other subjects they are for the external assessment. Okay, so this is about the curriculum at the secondary level. Okay, if we see the syllabus, so here we are talking about the secondary and higher secondary. So 9th and 10th comes under secondary, 11th, 12th comes under the higher secondary. And the syllabus of this secondary and higher secondary, it is revised and restructured time to time. And they are taking guidelines. From whom they are taking guidelines? From the NCERT, that is National Council of Educational Research and Training. And see, maybe you may have that question in your mind that NCERT they are taking so syllabus it is constructed and it is revised at the state level, and to keep the uniformity, even the curriculum, even the syllabus, they are taking guidelines from the NCERT, that is national agency, that is National Council of Educational Research and Training. Okay, but while restructuring the syllabus, okay, so whatever guidelines is given by the NCERT, the 7% approximately 7% syllabus is based on that guidelines, and the 30% syllabus have been framed on the basis of regional requirement and whatever situations are there as per the region. The 30% syllabus is framed according to the regional requirement. So this is not the fixed percentage. We can say the approximately 70% is based on the whatever guidelines are given by the NCERT, and 30% syllabus it is based on the regional requirements. Okay, so this is about the curriculum. I think you understood all the points. Yes, this is the small topic, and the you can say the first board, the Maharashtra State Board of secondary and higher secondary education, which is also called as SSC and HSC board. Okay, apart from this, They are also publishing magazines like Shikshan Sankraman, and from this magazine they are giving different educations regarding the new policies, regarding the new trends in the education. They are giving information through that magazine, and basically you can say that the main aim of this board is to improve the quality of the education. Okay, so this is all about the SSC and HSC board, or we can say Maharashtra State Board of Secondary and Higher Secondary Education. Okay, you understood about this? Yes, students, please give me your feedbacks. Yes, ma'am. See, this is very simple topic, but while studying any topic of any subject, okay, please remember that if university is going to conduct MCQs, so please study according to that only. Okay, so it will be easy for you to give examinations and to score good marks in your examinations. Okay student, I think this is now 11:26, our time is over, so I'm going to quit now. Thank you so much for listening today's session attentively, and please take care of yourself and your family. Okay, see you in the next lecture, and just wait for a minute. Okay, who is having second lecture today? Yes,
Pratipa.
Ma'am. Which? Yes. Yes, Meenakshi.
Geeta, yes. Ma'am.
Okay. Okay. Students, thank you so much. Bye bye.
Thank you, ma'am. Bye. Thank you.